Happy Vlogmas. Welcome to the Serenity Podcast Vlogmas episode. I am Tracy, the North Carolina half of the Serenity Podcast, and tonight we are having a campfire. If you followed me for any time on Instagram, you know this is something we do quite often in our household, and the weather's about to turn North Carolina cold in just a few days, and it's going to be really rainy. So we thought this was a good opportunity to sit outside and enjoy the weather a bit before it turned. Amy, Froggy Monkey, if you're watching this, our fire pit is totally designed after one that you showed on Instagram at one point. And every time we come out here to enjoy it, I always say, at some point when there's not a fire in the fire pit, I've really got to readjust these stones.
Too late.
This might be one of the few episodes where there's actually knitting content in my knitting podcast. All right, so we were talking about telling some ghost stories around the fire, and we have some pretty good ones because we live in a haunted house. And this whole thing starts back in... What year did the little people live in the house, Michael?
That's probably
20s and 30s and 40s, I don't know.
So the whole thing starts probably in the 1920s, but the legend came about in the 1980s. So when my husband and I were in high school, there was a legend about our neighborhood. I didn't know it was our neighborhood at the time. I just had heard the legend of Munchkin. Is it Munchkinville or Munchkinland? I don't remember which one we called it. But the legend was you would drive your car through this little Munchkinland, and when you got to a particular like intersection or stop sign, your car would cut off, the ignition would cut off, and you wouldn't be able to get your car to restart until you got out and pushed it past the stop sign into the street. But then while you were doing that, these tiny little people would come out of the houses with rocks, and they would throw rocks at you while you were trying to get your car restarted and jump back in and drive away. I never experienced this. It's local. Local legend that people would tell to scare people. It wasn't until we'd already bought this house and started the renovation process that I realized this was not just the Munchkin village, but it was the literal Munchkin house. Since then, we learned the origins of the story. Probably back in the 1920s, there was a family that lived here, and their children sadly had a degenerative bone disease, and each child was smaller than the one before, and the last two were wheelchair bound, and they would sit on the front porch during the day. So the brother would take them outside and put them on the porch and set them up with a pile of rocks they could use to throw at bullies who were antagonizing them during the day until he came back from school and could bring them back into the home. We met the older brother while we were doing our renovations. His name was Pete. He was also small, but not as small as his siblings had been. They had passed away since the story. And he scared Michael half to death when he was on a ladder and spoke to him, and he looked down and couldn't see anybody. Our house isn't haunted by spirits of little people, but when Renna was 3 or 4, she would tell us about the ghosts that were in our house. She described them as a boy who lived in her brother's room under the stairs, in the little closet he has under the stairs. And she said he wore overalls and no shirt. He just stood there all day. And there was a lady upstairs, a weeping lady, she called her, the crying lady, who wore all white and lived in her closet. And I asked her if she was afraid of them. Boys, come on. I asked her if she was afraid of them, and she said, no, they're benevolent.
Well, you still have a baby lighter in my room at this point. I had a nightmare, and I remember waking up crying. And then there was a lady that I thought was you who was like comforting me. And then I went to hug her, and she was just gone, and I fell face flat on the foot of my bed. And yeah, that was it. That's all I remember.
Pretty sure they're about to get.
Thank you.
What would he have done if it went in the fire?
He would have gone in the fire. He would have been a hot dog.
Yeah.
Back up. Okay, good boy.
Good boy.
That's all.
Good boy, you got my tail off. It's gonna fall off.
He's like, is there a note? What? I just did this.